Okay, let's start this page with the first prompt. Prompt A, to cover your page with scraps of napkin or tissue. And I have this pink and purple napkin. It's also got a bit of buttermilk in it as well. I didn't notice that. Almost buttermilk, it's like a pinky buttermilk. Anyway, let's just tear this up. I have a vague idea of what I want to do with this page for a change. I've had a good think about it, been at work because I've not had time to actually film. So I've just been thinking about it, reading the prompts over and over. So I'm just starting with mixed media paper today. Not sure why it's tearing so easily today. Perhaps it's the spatula's a bit rough. Yeah, I think it's snugging on the spatula. No, brush is way too hard. It's really windy today. Really windy. And apparently it's going to rain quite a bit. And I've got to go to work very soon. Doodling in this month's prompts, and I'm not a fan of doodling, but I think I know what I want to do, so that makes me feel a bit easier. I think with doodling I have to plan it, I can't just do it off the top of my head, it just looks rubbish if I do that. Okay, a bit more. Getting all sticky now. Okay. No, it's definitely pink. Not buttermilk. pink and purple down. And what I would like to do now is dry that and then come back with the painting with fingers. So I'll be back in a second. Okay, so let's get some paint out. So for my buttermilk colour I'm using Titan Buff, Titanium Buff. Ooh. It's been a while, so it's reluctant to come out. Let me see what I've got to poke that out with. Try this. Okay. Lift off. Now, can I get it to go back in? I don't think so. That's probably going to happen again if I don't keep using this paint. Which is annoying. I may have to slice it open and put it in a pot or something. Rid of that, that might be. No, that's just... okay, right. Anyway. Let's grab some magenta as well. This is Winsor & Newton. Okay, and this is very heavy bodied paint. So let me find my spray bottle. Oh. Here we go. And here's me thinking I was all organised. Let's just add a little water to that. And here we go. That feels like wet clay. Much water, I think. Oh well. See what I'm doing now, can you? mostly focusing on the white areas. I don't think we're going to have any white space left on this page today. I have blended a bit better in place. The magenta is quite bright, so I think I'm going to go in with the satin buff and just turn it down a bit. Okay. Put my hands on my apron. Make sure that tissue all blends in with the background. There we go. Right. And we've got to make marks. The circular objects, I do believe. So I'm going to use black actually. Because later on I'm going to be doodling in black and I want just a little bit of black in the background to tie it in. To grab a small lid. That's about it. I'm not going to bother to dry the background. yet. And okay, I think that's enough. So now I'm going to let that dry and have a look at the next step. Okay, so I'm going to need some botanical elements and Andron, and I'm going to do those on this book text, but I'm going to colour it first. I'm going to wet it. I love doing this, I've done this for ages. My two favourite colours in these inks, well, the main two colours I've got, Deep Violet in the Liquid Text ink. And quinacridone magenta, I think that's how you say it. Lashes on there, and a bit more water on top. So it really bleeds, and then I'm going to leave that to dry as it is. Hopefully it will move about on its own, spread, and look beautiful, hopefully. So I'll see you when that's dry. Right, it's still wet. I've just thought it's pooling quite a lot here, there's quite a lot of ink, so I'm going to just suck some of it up. It would take ages to dry, and it will dry thick and shiny and horrible, so I'll get rid of some of the thicker areas. Spread it about a bit. There we go, I'm a bit happy with that, so I'm gonna let that dry. I'm gonna let that dry now. Okay. Now, I'm going to be brave and I'm going to use my pen straight away. And I'm going to doodle my flowers. And these are loosely based on a hibiscus. They're just doodles, don't forget. It's going to be sort of stylized. petals, that's the first. Go back around, just give it that doodle look. And then in the centre they have a sort of thing that comes out, and I'm just gonna doodle that. That's one. Seems to be raining out there again today. I think that's the end of our lovely British summer. There we go. And that is my doodled flower. Doodled. What is it? Oh, what's the word? What's the word? Botanical element. So I'm going to bust my little tag with little dotsies, and I'm just going to grab my Wilted Violet Distress Ink. This tag has got one side shiny, one side is matte, so I've embossed the matte side, so that hopefully it will take this ink quite nicely. And I'm going to just gently go over the top. To catch the dots. There we go. love that. Okay. So now kind of want to tuck it in, but you still see that it's embossed and a little taggy and tissue or napkin, paint or colour with the fingers, make marks, circular objects. Haven't done a quote yet. Textured or embossed card, add doodles or scribbles. I'm thinking thinking a doodly scribbly border. Wishes potion purple or teapot purple? I'll get this one, witch's potion. And give it a good shake so that the mica disperses. And let's clear the decks a little bit. That's that. And let's get that dry. And then we can assemble the page. Okay. So that didn't take long to dry at all. I kind of went downstairs and made myself a drink, and when I came back it was dry. So the only thing I need to do is handwritten journaling, quote or text. I'm actually thinking of writing some journaling. I don't normally, but yeah, I think it'd be cool to have like some text and then the flowers covering it, and yeah. So, yeah, I'm going to do that. Here we go. There we go. Glue. What do I use? Let's go for the elms. Position these down again. Okay, and then I think I'm just going to lift it up. I'm not really fussed about it being completely stuck down. If it lifts, it lifts. Just add a little bit of a 3D feel. Yep, I like that. And then I'm going to pop a bit more on here. Tag in. And now I feel like I do want to pop a title on this still. Let's use the stamp press. Yeah, let's use that. That'll be good. Where is it? Where is it? Now then. What I'm going to do is I'm going to grab a ruler. Let's use this one. And then I can make sure my letters are nice and straight. I'm not going to use the words, suggested words. I think I've lost a lot of these letters. Don't know how. Right up there, so we know that's straight. Okay, I think I'm going to go over that again with the Posca pen. just to bring it out. This is just how I feel today. Can you hear the rain outside? It's supposed to be August, the height of our summer. And it actually, the past few days, it really feels like autumn. And I feel like I should be doing, you know, my Halloween projects, which I can't wait to get into, but would have been nice to have enjoyed some of the summer. But there we go, we live in England. So, today's date is the 14th. Let me find my 14th of August. Reason this bit doesn't seem to want to stop. Very well, there we go. Let's fix that. 14th August 2019. Just move it up a little bit, maybe that's the issue here with it. Right, so I think just want to grab. Let me go for the Dusty Concord because it's archival. I would use the Altered Violet, but it is not archival. Just want to add a little hint of darkness around the edge to bring it all in. Don't usually use pink. I know Mike hates purple. I hate pink. So there's a lot of pink on here for me, but actually, because I've used a lot of purple, it's, yeah, it makes it okay, I suppose. But there we go. I think that is me done. For the August mission inspiration. Can you see the glimmer that I've got going on there with the... My camera's trying to focus on something. Over here. I don't know what it is. Anyway. That's the page we've got going on there. It again. So I hope you enjoyed that. Please do join us on the Mission Inspiration Facebook group. I will share a link below. And thank you very much for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Bye bye.